to a disturbing stabbing spree in Boise, Idaho that left 9 injured, including 6 children. A 30-year-old suspect is now in custody, accused of targeting a child's birthday party, and now authorities are trying to zero in on a motive.
Tonight, police charging 30-year-old Timmy Kinner after a vicious stabbing spree at a kid's birthday party.
This was an attack against those who are most vulnerable, our children.
9 victims, 6 of them kids.
It's untenable, unconscionable, and it's pure evil in my mind.
Police say it happened Saturday night around 9. When they arrived, they described a horrific scene with victims scattered both in and outside the apartment.
They're requesting as many units as we can get.
According to police, Kinner briefly lived with a resident in the complex but was asked to leave. Saturday, he returned in a fit of rage.
Dispatchers sound like they've got one at gunpoint.
The apartment complex plays home to a large international population, and this incident has rocked Boise's refugee community.
Our victims are some of the newest members of our community, from Syria, Iraq, and Ethiopia.
The mayor has branded Boise as a welcoming community.
This callous act does not reflect our community.
4 of the victims have life-threatening injuries, but authorities say at this point in time, this doesn't appear to be a hate crime. As for the suspect, Kinner, he was taken into custody without incident.
He was chasing people and stabbing them. So we went inside the closet. Yeah, we hid in the closet. I brought him, my 2 sisters, and
the
1 more kid.
The tragedy was that a 3-year-old little girl was having a birthday party just a few doors down from where Kinney had been staying. Kinney attacked, targeting the children initially. The 3-year-old girl, whose birthday it was one of those seriously injured, including 2 4-year-olds, a 6-year-old, an 8-year-old, and a 12-year-old, along with 3 adults who tried to intercede to prevent the loss of lives of the children. Our victims are some of the newest members of our community. They're victims from their past homes who have fled violence from Syria, Iraq, and Ethiopia. Our suspect is a man with an extensive criminal record spanning multiple states who has spent time in prison and whose past criminal violations do include violence against others. He's not from Boise. The crime scene, the faces of the parents struggling, the tears coming down their faces, the faces of the children in the hospital beds will be something that I'll carry with me for the rest of my life, as will every first responder that was there last night. To the first responder, this was an attack against those who are most vulnerable, our children. It's untenable, unconscionable, and is pure evil in my mind. But there was, I do. So we have no specific evidence at this time to believe that it was a hate crime based on the specific evidence we have in our hands. However, due to the nature, location, and the victims, we are, of course, investigating all potential leads which might lead us to that conclusion.
Much of the Treasure Valley woke up to the news of a mass stabbing, not knowing what to do or how to comprehend the terrible event happening in Boise, a town usually left off the map when it comes to attacks and brutal acts of violence.
We're a welcoming city. We don't have areas of high crime. Most people that I know in Boise want to share our city with refugees and immigrants.
But after the stabbing of 9 people, some of whom were children and refugees, community members felt the need to come down to the neighborhood affected and make sure this act is not what Boise becomes known for.
No, this is not representative of Boise, and it shouldn't be representative of anywhere. I guess at the end of the day, the least we can do is show up and just say, we see you, and we love you, and we're sorry.
That apology for the acts of one man fell to citizens of Boise showing up at the Northwest Boise apartment complex with flowers, hugs, and to share in the grief and hopefully find a way to move forward together.
There's just so much divisive nature right now. It's an easy thing to leave flowers, but people feel alone, and they need to not.